Hi guys, it's Istaria here again. When I was young, I made a Prince of Persia custom map pack. It was like 2007, 2008, something like that. And I pretty much thought that no one would ever play it, but I made it for my own sake. I wanted a challenge in the game. The original was too easy, and I just figured I like creating maps. I have made maps for Doom and Prince of Persia and other games and stuff. But anyway, little did I know that there is a world record holder in Prince of Persia Classic, which is the game which was made in like 1990 or 89 or something, so super, super early. And he is running, or was running, this game in an event called Pop Runs. And he informed me about this, and obviously I wanted to tune in because, well, it's not every day you hear that a world record holder is running your mod in a game where you did like set up this whole thing over 10 years ago. So yeah, super interesting. And I thought it would be a very interesting thing also to make a reaction video to his run. So a little disclaimer, I have seen this video live when he played it, so I'm watching a replay now, but let's get started.
Let's go.
All right. So normally I turn off the sound when I do the any percent, but because this particular mod is so taxing, I leave the sound on just so that I feel some sort of accomplishment at the end of levels. So this is awkward. I have to jump here with a slow fall potion. Then I have to get into a specific situation so I can jump and just barely miss all these spikes down here.
Yeah, so this one here is completely optional. He doesn't need
just
to
barely
do this. And it's something you need,
but
to time
it gives
correctly.
Me a health potion or extended life potion or something like that, and a sword.
Yeah, so not necessary, but helps you along the road if you do this. You can also complete this level the normal way.
So I will be doing a lot of speed running type stuff, because I figure I know how to do it. There's no reason for me to not do it. But I believe this can be completed without using any of that.
Yes, it can.
I think. Be really cool if it could.
Yeah.
There is a few jumps that technically are not speedrunning or anything like that. They're just difficult. Have to be lined in the correct spot.
Yeah. So when I made this in 2007, I had
so
never
normally
seen...
you'd want to make each of the three guards on this bottom floor die on each of those things, but that's very difficult. I think I've only ever done it once like that, and then I realized that I didn't need to. And once you figure out you don't need to do something, it's very difficult. Well, you don't do it anymore, so. I hate this guard.
So yeah, when I made
this, I guess they call them guards because you can't let your guard down.
Never seen anybody play this game, and obviously I was not aware of any speedrunning strategies, and I don't think anybody even speedrun it at the time because it was so early, and that thing came later. So yeah, you can complete this with just regular movements and regular skill, but it's very difficult. No glitches or whatever, anything like that.
Alright. So this is one of those situations in which I have to be in a specific situation before I can jump here. I have to be right here.
And that is very impressive how he set that up.
So... technically, that's not a speedrunning strat. That's just playing the game. It's just kind of mean to expect someone to, you know.
Yeah, so it was intended that you would have to run.
We are talking about the original Prince of Persia, so there's, like, even in the actual game, so there's stuff like that.
You would have to run through those things, run and jump, instead of the standing jump.
Oh, look, I can jump through this, this gate.
So yeah, the standing jump
So that's a thing you can do.
But,
obviously, if I was, completing this the non-glitch way, I'd have all those guards dragged there, and then I wouldn't have to worry about getting through that gate in some fancy way. But
so yeah, the standing jump is really difficult to complete. As you can see, he is setting it up. He knows exactly where he needs to be. There is like four or five or so different positions in per tile, and you have to be in the exact correct one, or you will fall to your death. So yeah, super precise, and he is super good at setting it up.
Okay, this level is annoying, particularly because of a guard. Who is the same guard at the beginning of level 8 of the actual game. Some people call him the Lurker because he does not advance upon the prince. As long as you're so far away, he won't advance, he won't strike, he won't do anything. He'll just sit there and look at you funny. when my girlfriend first got to the stage and had to deal with my fiance had to deal with that guard, she was like, it's no fair if they're using my strats against me. Because, you know,
very impressive by,
because when she was first playing, that's how she'd kill guards. She'd wait for them to advance on her.
Yeah, so
while yelling, come at me, bro.
For his fiance to complete the first level to this level is very impressive, because it's super long and hard when compared to regular Prince of Persia levels.
That's what I get.
And yeah, that was a good demonstration of
that's what I get.
How consistent you really need to be. Even a tiny little positional error and you are dead. Like, what happened there?
Saw that coming. See, this part right here looks scary. It's not all that scary. Dealing with the guards is scary because the guards are the RNG in this game. The other RNG in this game is, of course, you, the player.
So yeah, here, what wasn't mentioned before is that you have to drop this guy down there into the spikes, so you can...
Which I think some people would
also
say that's not really RNG.
Otherwise, if you kill him up there, you will not be able to descend here.
Alright.
You will just die to these spikes.
So this is weird. The best way to kill this guy is to put away your sword, because he's that... Because he will advance on you if you don't have a sword out. Oh. Except for whenever he doesn't. So, I can't... I know, you're looking at this and you're like, well, why don't you just knock him off one of the sides? You can't do that. So if you knock him off this side that I'm facing, right there, that closes this gate that I just crossed. If you knock him over this side, it presses this button, which opens this gate, which you'd think would be fine, except for I have to hit that button that... Either way, you cannot knock him off the side.
Yeah, designing that room was...
It's a little trolly, but...
But it was...
That's just how that is.
Kind of difficult to fit all that in one.
Ooh, room, now we're going to fight some skeletons. Skeletons are fun. Who doesn't like skeletons? I like skeletons.
It's not really that trolly. It's more about... you have to...
Sometimes I think of myself as just a skeleton with skin on it.
I just had to force the guy to be...
Which is technically what I am.
Because dropping him
down
would be...
Or my skin with a skeleton inside. I don't know.
Is there nothing interesting about this?
He's wearing an Edgar suit.
Press that button one way or another. And can use the skeleton.
Yeah, I think I would like to... I would like to play the repetition of time. That's another one I'm going to work on. So, the Peedmaster, if you're wondering why I haven't increased my world record in about a month, it's because I've been working on this. And yes, it's taken me... This and Glitchless have taken me about a month to get to a point in which I'm not going to embarrass myself.
So yeah, that's set up.
Just the entire point. It's not really to be cool, it's just not to embarrass myself.
Really impressive, because when I tried to pass the skeleton to get through that
the
gate...
The Peedmeister was the one who actually wrote the auto-splitter that all of us Pop 1 players use, if I'm not mistaken. Am I forgetting something, or is that...
Yeah, so
it has been... We've updated it to do in-game time and stuff like that, but...
And yeah, about the auto-splitter he mentioned, I have no idea what that is, so I would have hoped he would have gone into more detail on it. Anyway,
this is a cool level because I learned a new, neat thing that I had not learned. Like, I already had the world record in this game, and... thought I knew almost everything except for this. If you hang from an edge, he'll fall forward. That's weird. No one told me that was a thing. I didn't know that was a thing. Learned it. Well, yeah, that's what I do. I'm a streamer. We shout out everybody. We're like, yo, my sister's in the audience. Everybody say hi to my sister. My sister's not in the audience. Is she? Tamara, are you in the audience?
Anyway,
no, she's not.
Yeah, so because he was able to do that trick and he collected all the health potions before in the earlier levels.
That's what sisters do.
This old version he is playing allows him to skip this level because he has enough HP to...
Say hello to your mother for me.
...use that shortcut there. So he... In the new version, this is no longer possible, and he needs to do this level, but he's playing the old one.
Do I deserve... Oh. Oh, so this is, like, a fun level, and by fun, I mean not fun. Okay, so I have to take a careful step forward before I start running. But otherwise, I do just run through these guys. But the careful step forward gets me the timing right so that I don't chop something off.
Yeah, again, he did that super precise jump from standing still, which in my opinion is a lot harder than just making the running jump. And that...
So I sent a message to the guy who made this mod on his YouTube channel. I don't know if he caught it.
Yes,
so,
he did.
But it would be cool if he saw it being played.
Indeed, exactly.
Now, he did update his mod. He saw me skipping a level that he worked really hard on and kind of bummed out that... Oh! So he changed it up. I'm not playing his new version because I still don't know how to beat that level. I'll learn at some point, okay? But I'm playing what I have. Oh. Pay attention to what you're doing. So now that I know he's in the audience, I can't say all of those things about how horrible this mod is and how it's frustrating and diabolical and that the person that made it's evil.
That's a slight exaggeration because I think this is just a nice challenge for somebody.
I mean, not that I was going to say those things, but I could have.
Because it doesn't require any glitches or anything like that.
Oh man, why are these guards such a pain in the butt?
Very high level of consistency and precision.
Whoa! Dude, why are you so violent? Why are you so violent? Come at me, bro. Oh, crap. Come on. Okay. That was a little intense. Alright. So, future mod makers. Please, more parts where I'm just walking up. I'm jumping up because I need opportunities every now and then to take a sip of whatever I'm drinking.
Yeah, again.
Okay, now comes the scary part.
Super precise.
This is the part that I'm like, I don't know if I jinx myself out or what, but I always mess this up.
Yeah, this part scares me also every time. It's so easy to mess up, even though it's not super difficult, but
I made it. So you have to drink that potion while you're on the tile that's falling. Otherwise you don't get to drink that potion. Hey, I don't kill that many enemies. I mean, I'm not exactly pacifist. Though, we have a new pacifist category. And, YOLO, I believe, is the one that, currently, you guys should totally, after Pop runs, watch his pacifist run of Prince of Persia. It is quite impressive.
I should probably do it. Sounds
and
interesting.
It's pacifist, even though Jafar has to die at the end. He does not strike any of the villains at any point, including Jafar. So if you're wondering how he kills Jafar without using the pointy end of the sword against him, go watch his run. It's pretty awesome.
There, I didn't mention because he was talking, but if you crap the ledge, you die. So you just have to jump past it, even though your first instinct might be to crap the ledge. So, small trap, if you will.
Do 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 do. All right. Which is the next level? This is. Oh yes, this is the level I'm totally skipping. The other day, I went over here. I was like, maybe I'll look at, and then I was like, no. I just looked over there, and I'm like, no, I'm not doing that.
So yeah, the some original other time. Intent here was nope. That if you collect every HP before
that looks
this,
like a whole bunch of nope to me.
Then you will be able to do this whole
I'll learn
descent
it.
Down.
but,
thing.
Mm.
But it's not
eventually.
So hard to get them all, so I figured I'd change it because that level is actually like the top three, in my opinion, top three most fun levels to play in this mod.
It's probably an awesome leap. Actually, I think it is an awesome level. You have to, like, do some cool guard manipulation.
Yeah, it's definitely worth.
So I had to push that guard off so that he took up this spiky thingy so I could land there. That is something that's going to happen later. You all right, Kaylee? Your foot hurts. Uh-oh. Oh, your pinky foot hurts. Oh, no.
This looks hard, but it's not that hard, but it's very precise at the end.
I want to watch Mr. Tim.
You cannot go any past the gate any longer than he's doing, because otherwise you will get chopped.
One, two, three. So here's a kind of a funny bit. Do this guard. Ain't no guard no more.
Yeah, that was not supposed to happen, but it's pretty cool. So yeah, you have three different routes you can take in this map. And I think this one was intended to be like a dead end. But with that trick, it's obviously not. So it might even be the best route to take.
Quite possibly. Although, aren't you the master of feet? Or am I... Or is that a ped master? I don't know. I don't know.
To be honest, I don't even remember what the other... The bottom route is
Stop
like.
Trying to do fancy stuff.
But the top one is really easy. Just go
get in there.
Else.
All right, so I skip most of this level. Ouch, this guy is very violent.
So yeah.
Woo!
When I
All right.
this level, I had no idea you could do that.
Yes, I just got the guard to push
However,
me through the gate.
I think getting him to push you through the gate is probably harder than the beginning of
no,
this level.
I do not do birthday parties, but I do bar mitzvahs, so...
So yeah, if you can do that, good for you.
Sorry, you get tipped well at bar mitzvahs.
So yeah, looks like in this level he has chosen the easier route, which is below. There is a... There is two different exits in this one, so you can.
Like I said, I do bar mitzvahs.
Do the upper one, but it's really difficult. Actually, I have never completed that part, so. But I think it's faster. Not sure. Probably is faster. So he should probably take a look at that if he wants to improve his time in this map. Because setting this bottom part is kind of.
Alright.
There is a lot of slow parts in this part here, so yeah. But yeah, this is definitely easier, but not so easy, anyways.
I hate chompers. Whoa!
Well, that wasn't supposed to happen. Not at all.
Son of a...
Yeah, so what happened was that he didn't actually kill the guy, so he somehow respawned and or got back to his old position and was there waiting for him. I've never seen something like that happen in this game before. Super weird, but kind of funny.
Hey, that's hilarious. That was not planned. That was not planned whatsoever. Okay, note to self, do not push the guy through the wall. Apparently, he comes back. Alright. Strategy I thought I could use. I mean, I was totally not expecting that guy to be there.
Here you can see that.
Just die already.
This level
Thank
of
you.
Respect, because although all the spikes are up,
he's
still just
health.
Walking past them, although he could be running. So.
I've never had that happen, but it's not like I'm surprised that it happened. I've had something similar to that happen before. For instance, if you hurt Jafar a little bit, but then you leave the room, and you come back, Jafar's at full health. Jafar's? Yeah, Jafar. Jafar's. Jafar is. I was thinking, like, it's a restaurant, Jafar's. Come to Jafar's, we have a full salad bar.
Just like before, there is a two-tile jump here.
With lots of hummus.
Standing running jump, or however you want to call it.
It's a hummus bar.
And one of the tiles
just
is going to drop off.
Bunches
so
of hummus.
You have exactly one shot.
Who doesn't like hummus? My mom doesn't like hummus. My mom hates hummus.
If you bump into the wall, no way to complete the level. If you're too slow, same thing.
All right, so I have to make him look the other way. Two. Two. Three. Of course, I did not have to wait that long, but those things scare me. So I did. Huh? Huh, what you gonna do now? Huh? You're stuck.
Yeah.
No, my mom does not like
this
hummus.
This level for him.
I think she doesn't mind chickpeas.
In the whole pack.
So, if you've played Super Mario Brothers, the original Super Mario Brothers, this pattern that I have to go through, I have to do top.
Only hard part in this map, this one. Timing this, climbing up the jumper, super hard. Really, really precise.
Bottom. Middle. Bottom. And top. I think it's the same. I think level 8, the castle. Super Mario Brothers, you have to do a pattern very similar to that. Or exactly like that. And that's basically all this level is. He was, I think. I might be mistaken.
Yep. So. Hard level when you haven't done it before, but once you have done it, becomes the easiest level in the pack. Take some time to get through that initially, because you have to go all the way to the end to find out which ones were wrong, and then you have to experiment.
All right.
A little bit of an annoying level, but whatever. I tried to make every level in this pack different from one another, so why not? And here, super unintended thing. He falls way too far should be an instant death.
I am not going to drink that potion.
Because it's perfectly positioned on top of the guard.
Oh, by the way, I just fell down a long distance and not died. Yeah, I think I did that by accident once in it.
Yeah.
It's a good thing, too, because this level...
Pay attention to this one here. Crap. Super precise. You have to...
Okay.
A standing running jump through a jumper. And this level is full of them if he hadn't skipped it. So, yeah, I actually discovered this on my own. Not
I
sure
do a careful step, I run jump in
me.
Here, I bump against the wall, and that is my surefire way of getting, hey, it's Winter
I
Thunder!
I uploaded the glitch on my YouTube channel after I fixed it for the new version. And but since he's playing the old version, he can still use the glitch. I'm not sure if he saw it from my YouTube video, or
switch sides with
if
it.
He stumbled upon it on his own, or if he somebody told him about it. But anyway, yeah, so this level by far is the most difficult in the whole pack. Like, I think this is more difficult than all the other levels combined, so it's almost a shame that he's skipping all of it. So there is a lot of super ultra precise jumper jumps and like slow fall potion, not this one but one previous to this, which you have to time perfectly.
There,
it's just super, super hard.
Is it possible that there's max HP in? Say, I transferred it to 1.14, so the screen would be different. It would work with the auto splitter.
Anyway, yeah. So this level in its entirety would be a challenge for him, definitely. So. I hope to see him complete.
Technically, if you just put away your sword quickly. Ow.
It's not a fun level, but it's basically what makes this mod hard. That one level. And yeah, here you have to do the spike thing again. And if you do it on the far end spike, then you take a damage because you cannot drop down.
You can just put away your sword and run away from that guy.
So it would be ideal to...
In the beginning, but
the
so
you can
get
through
unscathed. Oh no.
And yeah.
See, I should be able to do this.
He's doing so well that
yeah, I can.
You don't really even see
all
how
right.
punishing this mod can be. But every now and then something goes
come
wrong
at me, bro.
And yeah, you can see that then you start all the way from the beginning.
There we
and
go.
Now the positioning is right on this one, so
stop trying to do fancy
drop
stuff
down without taking any damage.
All right, so don't do that. Probably be smart if we didn't.
Yes.
But we can
that
do that.
Extremely interesting. Obviously not intended.
There's this guy on my Discord called Krem, and he actually posted pictures of the exact spots that I need to stand to do that particular glitch. And so now that I know how to do it, I believe you can only do it from one side, so I couldn't have done it on this side. I think. But it's actually pretty easy once you know where you need to be.
So yeah, that
I am not in the right position. I am in the right position
okay,
now.
So that glitch makes this level a lot easier because you can skip around half of the guards, which is a big deal. And also makes it a lot faster. You don't have to pass.
I'm not the only one who's ever discovered it. Oh, I have to walk. I have to walk quietly and carry a big stick into this next room because if this guy hears me, he turns around and then it's basically impossible to climb up here. And luckily, it sets you up perfectly to do that strat. So.
Since this level is all about just the guards, I'm not even bothered by.
So if I ever learned how to parry while I'm retreating away from these guys, I wouldn't have to hit them whenever I finally get to the other side of them. But for some strange reason, I haven't learned to do that yet. What am I doing? Stop! Stop! Stop doing stupid stuff.
Yeah, very straightforward. Otherwise, just a lot of guards and not so much HP. So you have to get through here without taking too much damage. So it's basically a level that tests your skill against the guards. And you can prepare for it by collecting a lot of HP from the first maps or levels.
Yeah, this level is like a marathon of dealing with guards. And if I ever did speedrun this, I'd probably want to not pick up big, huge health potions, which means I would have to go the long way through levels. And that would mean that this level would be very difficult. Now, I cannot run jump into this room. Yeah. That opens up the gate here, and this opens up the main door.
Yeah, so
for the next level.
I think
so,
the new version of this room looks a little bit nicer.
Actually, this might be a PB.
This one here.
I mean,
ugly, to be
I'm
honest.
Talking too soon. Obviously, I haven't completed the next level, which is. All these levels are great, guys.
Very interesting way to go into the exit here. He kind of turns around and does it instantly. I would never dare to try something like that at the end of that level. But he obviously knows his stuff, so... I'm not surprised he was able to do that.
And this level isn't even hard, it just requires specific movements. Like, there's little RNG in it. I think there's no RNG in it, there's no guards in it. There's no guards in it, there's Shadow Prince at the end, but that's it. I forgot a switch. I forgot a switch.
That's how you react.
Okay.
Forgetting a switch.
That's what I forgot. I forgot that.
Funny how he said earlier that this level is not even.
So
hard.
You have to, you have to knock that tile
but
down.
Yeah, it's true. It's not really that hard, like compared to something like.
Because it holds up, open a gate somewhere.
Something like level 10, which is. Like a gazillion times harder than this, but this is still a fun
like
level.
Like I said,
to play,
this level, it's not RNG heavy or anything like that. It just requires that you do specific things.
Yeah, so...
For instance, there, I needed to... I really needed to, step... I needed a careful step towards the side so that I could...
Yeah, I wonder what the Prince of Persia players call that walking or standing running jump thing, which you have to do with these two tile ledge thingies.
All right.
But yeah, that's
so,
what you need to do here. Like this.
Do I amuse you? You think I'm funny?
I guess this level is a little bit of trial and error, but also a lot of it is,
funny
a lot
what?
Of it is
funny,
pretty
huh?
straightforward. It's almost showing you where you need to go, which is up.
Yeah, sometimes. Yeah.
Like in the other levels I made, most of them are not as straightforward.
Because it's very specific in movement, I probably do a lot of movements that are superfluous just because I don't know how to do it any other way.
Nice.
I made it. All right. So,
that's a pretty
I should not screw this up. So in case you didn't know, that tile right there is gonna fall. So it means I have to do this.
Yeah, you don't want to drop those things or walk down there. So, but yeah, pretty straightforward still, I would say.
Took forever for that tile to fall.
I'm pretty sure you can do a
right.
Walking, running jump from top of there to save a
Looks
little
like
bit
like I
time.
Am doing good.
Might be mistaken.
Let me jinx myself by saying, looks like I'm doing good. Oh, man. You know, this would have been more entertaining had I died more. I'm sorry, guys. Shouldn't have practiced as much. Because it's a more solid run. Far less entertaining. I'm sorry. I failed you by not sucking. Of course, I could be speaking too soon. I could always die. All right. Oh.
Yeah, I'm a little disappointed by this last level. It's needlessly long. Like, it doesn't need to be. It's just annoying when you have to
walk. Well, I failed a couple of times, just not enough. Hey, that was that funny part, right? Where the guard appeared out of nowhere? That was pretty good.
And if you get this far, there's
and,
no way.
And, you know, the chances of me messing up this Jafar fight, they're high. Ouch. Then again, if I'm lucky, he'll just... No, he didn't.
Damn I guess it. He tried to force Jafar into the wall or something, where he would have instantly died, I guess. Or something. And now he has to.
Jafar's like, huh. I ain't afraid of no tile.
Do it the old-fashioned way.
Can't kill me with no tile. I'm Jafar.
Yeah, not that hard considering pretty much all the guards in this mod are equally difficult in skill, so. But yeah, here is one place where you can still screw up because that's too long of a jump to make.
And I got that correct.
Do this right here.
So, like if that. I'm not mistaken, this should be a new PB. Should be at the top of my ranks.
I may have made this Jafar fight harder in the final version, but I'm not sure. Could be that the room there is one style smaller.
We'll see. About to save a princess.
But yeah, basically he is done. And there is nothing else to it anymore. Just go to the exit, and the last level here is exactly the same as it is in the normal game, which is because there is a limitation. You cannot really do anything. You cannot really add any spikes or jumpers or anything into this map, so yeah.
Saved the princess.
It is what it is.
Oh. The tyrant Jafar lies dead, his power shattered. Throughout the land, the people of Persia hail their princess and the brave youth who saved her from the forces of darkness. No longer a stranger, he shall from this day forth be known as Prince of Istaria. Prince of Persia. Alright. That's, I think, the fastest I've ever done that. I think so. Let me see. Second fastest. Alright.
Alright. So, first of all, I have to be very thankful to Carl Gamer for letting me know that he's going to perform this run. Obviously, since I'm not a Prince of Persia player and not following the scene actively, I would have completely missed out on this, what was a really fun run, and it's obviously a lot of fun to see your work being played. Especially when it's super old stuff like 12 years ago, 13 years ago, something like that. So yeah, and I also am very happy that Pop Prince chose to include this in their event. And yeah, so I would be happy if Carl Gamer took the time to learn the maps 4, 6 and 10 in the fixed version. And I think he would be happy too, because map 10 is definitely a huge challenge even for somebody of his skill level, because it's a long map and super precise, lots and lots of stuff that he needs to get right. So basically he needs to learn all those obstacles or he will screw up one of them and it's all over at that point. So yeah, so super high level of consistency needed in that level. And level 4, nothing special, just like a jump or two, like comparable to the early levels, not hard. But level 6 is a lot of fun to play, so yeah, I think he would enjoy it greatly if he took the time, which is probably like 30 minutes or less to get it. It's not so hard. Like, there is a lot harder stuff in this mod than level 6, but yeah, it's a lot of fun. It's maybe even my favorite level of the whole pack. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this reaction video I made into this, or I made, and I hope to see you in the next one. Thank you.